Hi, my name's Adam, and we're doing rapid acting insulin.
We have some signs and symptoms of hypoglycemia, which is confusion, tachycardia, arrhythmias, blurry vision, and diaphoresis. Our onset is 10 to 30 minutes, our peak is 30 minutes to 3 hours, and our duration is 3 to 5 hours.
We have a picture here just to help you remember the different types of insulins. This is a river raft, so it's rapid acting, so he's in the river rapids. This is your insect, so insulin, and you'll see the different insects that are flying and getting each one of these different types of insulin. We have the insulin lispro, which is represented by a pro with big lips. He's on top of a human log, Humalog. You have insulin aspart, which we have represented here with an ass with a part in his hair. And he's on top of a novel log. There's a novel on the log. And then we also have a glue lizard for glulosine.
And that's rapid acting insulin.
Hi, my name is Carrie.
My name is Danielle, and we're going to be talking about short-acting insulin.
The uses for short-acting insulin are to improve glycemic control, and the doses are 0.05 to 0.4 units per kilogram. That's for the sub-Q route. And then for the IV route, it's 0.1 to 0.2 units per kilogram. And the adverse effects are hypoglycemia, hypokalemia, lipodystrophy, pruritus, arrhythmia, swelling, and anaphylaxis.
And we have the two different sections for the onset. So for the sub-Q, we have 30 minutes to an hour. The peak is 2 to 5 hours, and the duration is 5 to 8 hours. And we have for the IV is onset of 10 to 30 minutes. The peak is 15 to 30 minutes, and the duration is 30 to 60 minutes. And as far as the sub-Q goes, you inject 30 to 45 minutes before a meal to ensure the onset of action coincides with meal absorption. And then we have a picture up here that represents the short acting. So we have a short ruler next to the short insulin or insect, so that will represent the short acting. And then we have the big R that represents the regular insulin, and the name Humulin. We have a little human that represents the Humulin in the injection.
Hi, I'm Holly.
And I'm Lindsay.
And today we're gonna talk about intermediate acting insulin. The onset is 2 to 4 hours, the peak is 4 to 10 hours, and the duration is 12 to 16 hours. It's used as a basal background insulin to maintain blood glucose levels in between meals and overnight. It contains protamine, which is what makes it look cloudy. It also makes it a suspension formula instead of a solution. This is also why they have to be mixed before being drawn up. When drying up insulin, always draw regular first. The dose is 0.5 to 1 units per kilogram per day.
And a little picture to help you memorize this, it's your in the middle insulin insect. Your isophane NPH, which is also your Humulin N, is represented by the ice fan blowing on Neil Patrick Harris.
Hi, I'm Caroline.
And I'm Kayla, and we're doing long-acting insulin. Long-acting insulin is a maintenance insulin, and it's used to maintain the blood glucose levels throughout the day.
And the signs and symptoms of hypoglycemia are increased thirst, headache, blurry vision, increased urine output, weight loss, fatigue, and fruity breath. So there are two kinds of long-acting insulins. The first one is insulin glargine, and the doses are, for type 1, it's 0.2 to 0.4 units per kilogram once daily, and for type 2, it's 0.2 units per kilogram once daily. And the second kind is insulin detemir, and the dose for that is 0.1 to 0.2 units per kilogram once daily, or 10 units once daily.
And we have the onset is 0.8 to 1 hour, the peak, there is no peak, and then the duration is 16 to 24 hours. And then we have this long insect to represent the long-acting insulin, and then a dead meerkat for detemir, and then a gargoyle in jeans with a lance for glargine and lantus.
We're going to teach you how to draw up insulin. So you're going to draw up air. inject it into your vial, and then draw up the amount needed, making sure there's no air bubbles. Once that's done, you're going to inject it into the subcutaneous tissue of your patient.